And then when they get to 70, that's where the big problems start, because the French haven't invented a word for 70.
I always assume the one thing that is kind of international is numbers and mathematics. That's the one thing that is the same everywhere. You're about to ruin this, aren't you?
Yes, I am. One thing that that you learn when you're studying a foreign language is that counting systems are very different. And in fact, it's one of the ways that you can tell if somebody's a really good speaker of a foreign language, you can really tell what their real mother tongue is when they start counting. Because even if somebody operates, you know, an English person living in France, when they start counting to themselves, they'll probably count to themselves in English. You know, they're our closest neighbours, so you'd have thought that maybe they count in the same way as us. But one of the things that I have to keep repeating to my students is that, in fact, the French don't count in the same way, and they use numbers in very different ways in a whole range of different everyday environments. Let me give you some examples. So the French, well, what do we do in England when we're counting numbers? We give numbers the first 12 numbers when we're counting, we give them individual names, so we go 1 to 12. And then we slip into a thing where we go 13, 14, which is kind of 3 and 10, 4 and 10, and so forth. The French start off in a slightly different way, they go a bit further. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then they go for a 17, so 17, 10, 7, 18, 10, 8, 19, 10, 9, and then 20 for 20. It's very similar, the counting system after that, to English. So they go on to 20, I just said was 20. Then they go to 30, 30, 40 for 40, 50 for 50, 60 for 60. And then when they get to 70, that's where the big problems start. Because the French haven't invented a word for 70. Instead, what they do is they count to 60 and add 10. So whereas we go to 60 and then go to 70, a French person goes to 60, but then goes to 60 plus 10, because they say 70. 70 is 70 in French. 70 literally means 60, 10, but it means 70. Oh, they know what the number 70 is. They don't sort of do this plus business. And a French person, when they hear you say 70, they don't think, oh, that's 60 and 10. They see 70. So the mental picture that is conjured by the sound of 70 is still 70, the same as we would. And then they continue by, instead of saying, they haven't invented a word, for example, for 71, so that's 71, literally 60 and 11. And it's rather odd with these ones that they say 71, e is the word for and, because when they get to 72, they just say 72, okay, 72, 60, 12. And it's only when we're dealing with ones that they use the E. But it gets even more confusing from the English point of view, because you think, okay, so we've got 60, 10, that's 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79. What do they do when they get to 80? Surely they've got a word for 80. Well, no, because the French, when they get to that number, they say 80, which means 420s. Well, that's what it means, 420s literally. The French, of course, when they hear 80, see 80 in their minds, and then they go 80-1, 420s, 1, 420s, 2.
Not 420s and 1.
No, they just be, the reason they don't say 420s and 1 is because it's too many words. So there's also a style issue here, because, you know, the French love their style. But what they do then, and this is the other weird thing, when they get to 90, they still haven't even thought of another word for 90 or a decent word for 90. So what do they say? They say 90, 420s, 10. And then when they get to 91, they say 91, 420s, 11. 92 is 92, 93 is 93, 94 is 94, 95, 95, and so it goes until they get up to 100, and they have invented a word for 100. So 100 is song. One of the big problems, of course, with this kind of numbering system is when you're listening to somebody giving you a phone number. Because if I could just explain, let me think of an English phone number. So you might have, you'd have 0115, so that's your Nottingham code. Then you have 962, would be the subcode for the exchange. And then the individual number would be 5782. And in English, we would read out all of the numbers, 0115, or we might say 0115, 962, 5782.
This isn't a real number, by the way, is
no,
it?
No, I just made that one up. Okay, so that's your an example of an English telephone number. But in France, they do it completely differently. They will take the numbers and they will actually distinguish the numbers 62, 58, 49, 27. And when you ask somebody for their phone number, they will tell you that it is 62, 58, 49, 27. They won't say...
They'll do that for all numbers, will they?
They'll do that for all telephone numbers. They won't say 625, 849, 27. And this causes, not big problems, but if you're on the telephone to a client in France who wants your mobile number, and you're used to giving your mobile number in the way the English do, and then you try to do it to the French, they find that very difficult to cope with. And it works in the other direction. My students are endlessly telling me about the problems they had copying down telephone numbers, and of course the really big problems start when you get to numbers that start with a 6, with a 7, with an 8, and with a 9. Well, it's a problem because if you're English and you hear 60, let's remember that numbers that what we would call 60 to 69 start with the word 60, but so do numbers 70 to 79. Let's say that your friend starts saying, my number is, I say in French, mon numéro c'est 60. You start, you do that, and then they say, et 11. You have to go back and correct it because it's not 60 at all, it's 71. But the other thing that the French do with numbers while we're on the subject, that's the French for 10.69. Let's say that that's the world record for the women's 100 metres dash in the Olympics. Okay? Now you can see that's very different from the way that we would write it in English. It's also very different from the way that we would say it. Now there we've got a decimal point and the French are using a comma, but they also say it differently. In English we say 10.69 because we separate the tenths and the hundredths, okay? But the French would say 10.69. Okay, so you have to listen out very carefully. If you're watching a French sports commentary, for example, if you're watching the Olympic Games in France and you're trying to catch the time, you have to listen out for not 10.69, but 10.69. 10.69. So once again, you've got this issue of numbers being grouped together. And that's something the French do all the time. They don't separate individual numbers out, they group them and give them and use their name. Yeah, the word the French use for a comma is a virgule, and they use that in grammar as they use it in numbers as well. So when a French person reads out this time, then they will say 10.69.
To a French person, is that 10.695 or is that 10,695?
It's 10.695. So it would be 10.695. That would be the way they express it.
How would a French person write 10,695?
Well, they would either just do that, and very often they leave a space. In a French textbook, you might find that there's a space between the thousands and the 695. Or occasionally, this is going to confuse you, just occasionally, they'll do that. 10,000, full stop, 695. So in fact, you could say that the French and the English do exactly the opposite thing, and you could argue that it's just to confuse each other and it's deliberate. Well, I don't have a problem with it, but it has caused problems in the past. There was a case of, a rather unfortunate case, in a French hospital a few years ago where there was a serious, too large a dose of something was administered to patients simply because of a misreading of a decimal point for this, or a comma not being read the right way around. So it can be a big problem in technical translation. Technical translators need to be absolutely sure that they get it right, because otherwise it can go very, very wrong.
If you'd like to hear a bit more about French numbers, including why it's impossible to score 20 out of 20 in France, check out another video we've got here on Numberphile. Or if you'd just like to hear more about languages in general from people like Paul and others, check out another channel I've got called Words of the World. It's got all sorts of fascinating videos about things like California or biscuit or vodka. There's loads of videos on there already, and there's new ones going on every week, so maybe subscribe.